In exactly 2 weeks from now, America will vote to elect its 46th president. November 3rd is the big election day. More than 30 million Americans have already voted. The remaining are perhaps waiting for the last presidential debate. And yes, it is happening, the last debate, unless another calamity strikes the presidential candidates. On Thursday night, Donald Trump and Joe Biden will share the debate stage for the last time. The first time was full of fireworks.
I'm the moderator of this debate.
Wrong guy, the wrong
number. You were a disaster. Your own chief of staff said you were. Don't ever use the word smart with me.
He's Putin's puppy.
Let people know you're a senator. I'm not going to answer the question.
Why
because,
would you answer that
because
question?
Because the
you
question is,
a lot of
the
new
question
Supreme
is,
Court Justice, the radical question, left.
Will you shut
who is
up,
on,
man?
Listen, who is on your list, Joe?
This
who's
is
on
so
your list?
Right.
Gentlemen,
this is,
I think
this
we've
is
ended
so
this.
He's going to pack the court.
We have en-
not
no,
going to give a list.
We have ended this segment. We're going to move on to the second segment.
That was really a productive.
The first debate was a shouting match. Will the last one be different? The Presidential Debate Commission is trying to make it different. They've introduced a mute button, meaning the debate organizers will mute a candidate's microphone to prevent the kind of chaos we just showed you. But it may not work. Why do we say this? Look at the topics of debate and you'll understand. Fighting COVID-19, American families, race in America, climate change, national security, leadership. The US president seems to be on the back foot on most of these issues. His campaign managers are not happy with these topics. They're already protesting. They want foreign policy added to the list. And they're accusing the debate commission of being biased towards Biden. Trump's campaign manager put out a letter to the quote-unquote Biden debate commission, as he calls them. He says the commission has ceded to the wishes of the Biden campaign. They're also gunning for America's top health expert, Dr. Anthony Fauci. Dr. Fauci, remember, has always been at loggerheads with the president over his pandemic response. For a while, Donald Trump pretended to be getting along with him, but then he shared his true feelings. Listen to this.
People are tired of hearing Fauci and all these idiots, these people that have gotten it wrong. Fauci's a nice guy. He's been here for 500 years. He called every one of them wrong. And he's like this wonderful guy, a wonderful sage telling us out. He said, do not wear face masks a number of months ago. He said, do not close it up to China. Don't. I have a list of 15 things this guy. And yet, we keep him. Every time he goes on television, there's always a bomb. But there's a bigger bomb if you fire him. But Fauci's a disaster. I mean, this guy's, if I listen to him, we have 500,000 deaths. And let me tell you one other thing. We saved 2.2 million people.
You heard him. An idiot. A disaster. A wonderful sage selling us out and somebody who's been here for 500 years. This is what Trump thinks of America's biggest viral disease expert. And no, this is not some locker room talk. This is being said in election rallies.
And Dr. Fauci said, don't put on masks. Don't put, you see the thing. And now he says, put on masks. And they say, you know, he's a wonderful guy. And he is a wonderful guy. I like him. He just happens to have a very bad arm. He has a bad arm, but he's a good guy. He's a good guy. A lot of our people don't like him. I like him. You have to understand him. He's a promoter. What can I tell you?
He's entertaining, but we didn't know you had to be good at baseball to be a health expert. Surely you have to be good at baseball to be a good president. Look at this tweet. Meanwhile, Joe Biden has gone off the campaign trail. He is said to be preparing for the presidential debate. His campaign managers are still at work. Last night, they managed to display light projections promoting Biden and Kamala Harris on several landmarks across American cities. This included buildings owned by Donald Trump. Look at these images. The words Biden-Harris reflected on the Trump International Hotel and the Tower Building in Chicago. Meanwhile, in Arizona, a key state for this election, some Republicans have decided to turn their back on Donald Trump and vote for Joe Biden. Why? Here they are explaining.
This is a sign, Arizona Republicans for Biden. We're current or former Republicans that think that Biden would be the best choice, even though we're Republicans.
I think I'm more voting against Trump, although I do think that Biden is the better candidate.
I voted for Donald Trump 4 years ago, and I'm voting for, or already sent in my ballot for Biden, because I'm all for a lack of, against this lack of civility and empathy that's in the Republican Party right now.
The race to the White House seems to have transformed into one big dancing tournament. After Donald Trump's killer dance moves went viral, Kamala Harris decided to show some of her own. And she took it to the next level. At an election rally in Florida, Harris danced in the rain with an umbrella. Will she be able to dance her way into the vice presidential office? We'll have to wait and see in a couple of weeks. Until then, look at this. Girls, I hear you've been running from the beautiful queen that you can be becoming. You can look in my palm and see the storm coming. Read the book of my life and see I'm overcoming. Just because the length of your hair ain't long. Thank you for watching Gravitas on Vyond's YouTube channel. If you want to stay up to date with what's happening around the world, then subscribe to our channel and don't forget to like and share. Thank you very much for watching. Vyond, world is one.